Alrighty, moving on to plastic recycling. A lot of people don't realise that you can't actually put a lot of plastics in regular recycling bins.
So we met up with plastICS, a group of international award-winning student environmentalists, and they talked us through the problem of single-use plastics.
Check it out.
Hi, I'm Ava.
I'm Angelina.
I'm Kiri.
I'm Isabel.
I'm Elise.
I'm Scott.
And I'm Monica.
We are all students at Illawarra Christian School.
And we are the task force for preventing litter and stormwater trash in community schools.
But you can call us plastics.
You've probably heard the term soft plastic before. It means any plastic that is scrunchable.
Soft plastics are bad for the environment because if they aren't recycled, they can take hundreds or even thousands of years to break down.
And even worse, if that plastic is littered, it can end up in our oceans, where our sea creatures can mistake it for food.
There's a lot of information out there about reducing and recycling plastic, but not a lot of it actually tells kids how they can help the environment.
So we wanted to start where it really counts, in your lunchbox.
We want you to think about your lunchbox. How much single-use plastic do you have in there?
If you wrap your food in plastic, you probably scrunch it up and chuck it in the bin. But if you do that every single day of the week, that's about 200 balls of scrunched up plastic in the bin per year.
And if there are 25 kids in your class all doing the same thing, that's 5,000 pieces of plastic per year that won't biodegrade.
So what can you do to help?
Number one, think about your lunchbox. Do you really need that much plastic?
Number two, start recycling.
Soft plastics is what we wrap our lunches in, but they can be harder to recycle than hard plastics, such as plastic bottles. That's where you come in.
You can start a recycling program at your school. We put bins out to collect soft plastic and then take turns to drop it off at local specialised recycling centres.
It means that instead of it sitting in landfill or ruining our oceans, it can be turned into useful products and sustainable housing.
And number three, remember that plastics are forever.
We use plastic all the time because it's easy. Plastic straws, plastic cups and plastic cutlery. But once we're done with them, they don't disappear.
So next time you buy some takeaway to eat at home, make sure you use your normal knives and forks.
Carry a refillable water bottle in your bag so you don't have to buy a disposable bottle.
There's loads of other ways you can reduce your plastic impact on the environment, but the first step is to be aware of it.
Because this doesn't look like much, but it all adds up.
And you don't have to start big by organising a recycling program at your school.
You can just commit to putting one less piece of soft plastic in your lunchbox.
Reporting for News to Me from the Illawarra,
we've been plastics.
Now back to the studio.